Hi, I'm Susan Iglukak. I'm a National Arts Center teaching artist. And this is part two of my four-part series called Your Lens, My Eyes, Reflections on Truth and Healing. Today I'm going to talk about specifically the Hound of Dolgmute and the relationship to Taheok and my mother, and how her recalling and sharing has played a role in my coming to truly feel a sense of belonging. And to start to understand what exactly it is I belong to, which has contributed largely to my healing and to my art. I ended my first segment with a picture of my great-grandmother, Taheok. The picture and image that my mother has when she talks of her. My mother's birth and formative years were spent with Taheok. What I came to ask myself through my songwriting, writing, and art is how not talking about and learning about Taheok and my mother's formative years or the transition years allowed for the wrong narrative to be reinforced, and how it is critical that we collect and connect with these stories so that we begin to correct the narrative. And as it is being corrected, we are purging untruths, and this becomes part of our healing. Some of those untruths are the words that were used in our formative years to describe Taheok's generation and our ancestors. As a young child, I remember words like primitive or barbaric being used in describing our grandparents and our ancestors. I remember hearing things like, what is wrong with those people? They are useless, and so on. And so as a young child, I took those descriptors to heart. And so I became silent when it came to those conversations because I didn't know how to deflect such hurtful words. This is the truth. Part of correcting the narrative for me is tracing words like that or descriptors like that, understanding the effect of those words, and also tracing Inuit family history and trying to understand what some of the words might have been used in their time and tracing that trauma, coming to understand their experience and what it must have been like. And this is part of putting those pieces together. Taheok is part of that story, but hers is very recent because she adopted and raised our mother. And so we learned of her through our mother, who is still with us today. I collect those memories, words, feelings, and emotions and turn them into writing and songs, replace those words with art and other creations to correct the narrative and create a new set of reinforcements. In this process, Taheok's story is important because my mother is important to me. And as I said, she is important. She's my mother, but she's still with us. And she is that connection to that generation, because she remembers. So again, briefly, who were the Haunik Dolmute? The Haunik Dolmute were one of the Inuit groups that occupied the Kivalliq region. And my mother's people, my mother's Haunik Dolmute being from the Alviat Rankin Inlet group of Inuit. And these are pieces that should be part of a curriculum in our education system that we need to teach and we need to learn. As I find these pieces, old perceptions or images I had of Taheok become clearer, and these start to form a mixed media piece of Taheok that I've decided to try to create. With each piece, Taheok becomes less distorted. The distortion is returned to its rightful place. It no longer has a place in my heart and in my life. And so the image of Dahilk also becomes more whole and more clear, allowing for me to have a greater sense of belonging and to become stronger. Early years were a great deal of uncertainty, and I felt it deeply. Uncertain about many things as an Inuk and as an artist. But as I learned and became more informed, I have become more certain of who I am and where I come from. And I'm no longer silent. And I replace those words with other words and reinforcing words that I need. As I create the mixed media piece of Dahilk, I write also the accompanying poem, Uncertainty. The strong emotion that stayed with me in the early years was often the question, how do we get through this? How do I get through this? How do I fill these spaces? How do I frame this? This is that poem. Una, nagligiyaga. I love this woman. Katiraw si mangitaga. I have never met her. Tusak si mayaka. Unipkaw siit. Tay matung mata. Taguna, kaw imavaga. I know her through songs and stories and memories. Taguna, kaw imagapku. Kau yimabunga, damna nagliusulawman. Because I have heard these stories, I know that this woman loved. So, why the uncertainty? Where did this come from? Why, like my mother, couldn't I just feel? Just feel loved, feel nourished. Know absolutely that I am working hard to be a good human being, as my mother felt because her grandmother Dahilk raised her that way. So these pieces come together. They form a less distorted visual of Dahilk. The visual I am returning to is the clearer one my mother has of Dahilk. When she speaks of her and she thinks of her, she imagines this Dahilk. That's the one we are returning to. That's the one I am returning to through my mixed media art. As I created, as I find these pieces, the visual is less distorted. My own life and the pieces that I have been putting together fall into place. I become more whole as a person, more whole as an Inuk, more whole as an Inuk in the contemporary world. In the narrative that I invested in were all these bad words. I replaced them with the good words, words that come to mind when my mother speaks of Dahilk. She loved, she was strong, and she sacrificed. Those descriptors are of a person who was incredibly loving and strong, not weak, not barbaric, not primitive. So those words get replaced. So it is an exciting time to live as an Indigenous person, as an artist, and these opportunities to create these pieces. Please join me in my third video where I will share with you the next part of the mixed media piece and how the language I'm learning, the way that I'm learning to communicate traditionally, the traditional ways that we communicate, inform who I am as an artist and the art that I create. Thank you very much.